The first is Hong Kong, Dr. YIBIN FENG. Dr. FENG is currently the professor come acting director with the duties of research, teaching, clinical consultation, administration, and service at the School of Chinese Medicine, Li Ka Shing Faculty of Medicine, the University of Hong Kong. At the same time, he is a principal scientist in Hong Kong University, Shenzhen Research Institute. He is also a Hong Kong registered Chinese medicine practitioner and a consultant physician at the University of Hong Kong, Shenzhen Hospital and Gleneagles Hospital. He also serves as a visiting professor at several universities in mainland China and overseas. He received his bachelor and master education in Chinese medicine mainland China. Dr. Feng completed his PhD training in Western medicine and biomedical research in Japan. His teaching subjects are pharmacology and toxicology of Chinese medicine and internal Chinese medicine. His presentation title is Chinese Medicine Treatment and Prevention of COVID-19 in Hong Kong, the People's Republic of China.
Good afternoon. Many thanks for Chairman's kind introduction. I also would like to take the opportunity to thank for the conference organizer and Dr. Song for inviting me to this conference. My topic is prevention and treatment of Chinese medicine for COVID-19 in Hong Kong. There are two legal medical systems in Hong Kong, Western medicine and Chinese medicine. Because Hong Kong have to do the treatment in infection disease measure situation. So Chinese medicine is not allowed to use it in hospitals until now. So today, I will talk some Chinese medicine measure for COVID-19 in Hong Kong by its research, prevention, and rehabilitation. Here is the epidemiological study by WHO and China and Hong Kong. As you can see here, the different area have a severe pandemic of COVID-19 until now. As of December 1, 2020, there have been more than 60 million confirmed cases of COVID-19 and more than 1.4 million deaths. Korea also have some severe situation. China and Hong Kong also now still in severe pandemic in Hong Kong. Here is a strategy in COVID-19. This model covers all aspects of COVID-19 research, including ethical consideration and the integration of social science, and also medical science and but the lake of Chinese medicine or other traditional medicines. I'm from School of Chinese Medicine, the University of Hong Kong. The University of Hong Kong has ranked number one knowledge helper in the world by its research paper citation. Some of potential therapeutic targets, vaccine for COVID-19 worldwide was highlighted in here. The number of COVID-19 related articles is increasing repeatedly, according to WHO report from last year, December to November this year, more than 100,000 papers have been published in various languages. The themes cover clinical manifestations, treatment operations, vaccines, virus structures, antiviral drugs, and diagnostic methods. But science also published a paper to say low quality papers of COVID-19 are flooding. Researchers should not take advantage of the pandemic crisis to lose their moral mission. New research topics, I suggested the number one is COVID-19 and other diseases. Number two, COVID-19 and traditional medicines. As you know, China has used traditional Chinese medicine at the beginning of the COVID-19. And now China have a good situation in control COVID-19. After Chinese medicine practice, government recommended three drugs and three prescriptions for nationwide use. For some reported herbs and formulas, there are many basic research and clinical research. As you can see here, one group reported one paper for by systematic analysis of single Chinese herbal medicine and the possible active compounds and the chemical skeleton analysis. And another groups also reported some formulas used in clinical practice and focused one formulas in clinical trial and demonstrated these formulas may effective to shorten the COVID-19 causes in clinical settings, and also can reduce symptoms of COVID-19 patients. After did a lot of basic research and clinical research in China, why we still need to do bench and clinical study for Chinese medicine again against COVID-19. Here's some death ratio from different countries. It is roughly calculated by WHO data on December 1, 2020. As you can see here, the lowest the country is Singapore, but the highest country is China. as you know, because China uses Chinese herbal medicines combined with the Western medicine to treatment of disease, it is get quickly controlled in mainland China. But from this ratio, it's hardly to say Chinese medicine is works. So I think we can have several reasons to explain this. Number one, this ratio needs to be elaborated by medical conditions, social conditions, age, sexual, other diseases, and psychological issues. And also, whether combination with traditional medicine treatment or not, for important issue to further evaluation. General issue need to be addressed, lifestyle, behavior, and traditional medicine prevention. So there are scientific and clinical evidence for traditional medicine prevention and treatment in COVID-19. But we need to further study about these issues. So in Hong Kong, some group have reported the total overview situation in mainland China to use Chinese herbal medicine and also get some clinical significant outcomes. And one group also reported the effective formula, Qingfei Paidu Decoction. There may have pharmacological effects and network pharmacology of the herbs, how to work on the COVID-19. And also published general papers to analyze all aspects for traditional medicine in COVID-19 by Chinese articles. In Hong Kong Yale, some groups, Professor Zhang groups also begin to clinical study with mainland China groups. Some drug discovery and mechanism of action in my group, in Dr. Chen's group and the professor's group also undergoing. The one of Hong Kong Yale groups first reported some several herbs may work on ACE2 proteins. It also one target of the SARS. So because in Hong Kong, now the COVID-19 treatment in hospital is not allowed Chinese medicine patient to participate because it is belong to infection disease. And now Hong Kong, no hospital and infection disease for traditional Chinese medicines. So government encourages Chinese medicine practitioner participate in rehabilitation treatment or prevention treatment. So my group also applied for government funding for prevention treatment. Now, several vaccines are in clinical trials and some of them have used in acceptable population. Recently, messenger RNA vaccine created by Moderna and biotech Pfizer also launched in marketing. Based on the research results of messenger RNA vaccine. Attracted by the world. So why we should do research on prevention of COVID-19 by traditional medicines? It is because the following reasons. Vaccine effect confirmed by some clinical trial, but we don't know long-term effect of the vaccines. Number two, Harvard University also published a paper in Science saying COVID-19 may break outbreak repeatedly according to mathematical models. And some clinical study also show that you may have an antibody after coronavirus infection, but it may disappear quickly. And some reporter also reported that COVID-19 may twice infection by some persons. SARS-CoV-2 will become the top killer of the elderly or weak people with various diseases for a long time, and the overall medical expenditure of humanity will raise sharply, and life expectancy will decrease. So how to protect vulnerable and susceptible peoples? It is a question. But for Chinese medicine, the diet treatment and herbal medicine intervention based on the theories of body constitution of Chinese medicine and combination of prescription of symptoms to improve COVID-19 susceptible body constitution and strengthen body defense are impossible. So we started a clinical trial and basic research for some Chinese herbal medicine for its prevention of COVID-19. As you know, there are three steps for model malaria, modern malaria of prevention for infection disease, including COVID-19. Number one is controlling transmission routes. Number two is cutting off pathogens. Number three is reducing susceptible population and strengthen body defenses. We will focus on the late two. According Lancet and other research studies, medial susceptible population of COVID-19 is 49 years old. And according to literature and Chinese medicine practice and the experience, we think some potential target for Chinese medicine treatment and prevention. For the prevention, we use the deficiency of qi and yin, and using the formula YIBIN FENG and Liu Wei Di Huang formula. For treatment purpose, we mainly focus on the Huang Lian Jie Du decocations. Here is the YIBIN FENG formulas. Cover three single herbs, Huang Qi, Fang Feng, Bai Zhu. This formula have reported by various infection disease by its prevention effects. Now it is used in more than 10 cities in mainland China for COVID-19 prevention. Liu Wei Di Huang declaration consisted of Su Di Huang, Xuan Zhao Ren, San Yao, Zhe Xie, Fu Lin, Mu Dan Pi. This Liu Wei Di Huang formula is a classical prescription for liver and kidney yin deficiency. So we will combine these two formula for the following symptoms: tiredness and weakness, shortness of breath when moving, fear of heat, 5 heart cold, self perspiration and night sweat, red tongue, wing white, skin white or light peeling, weak and fast pulse. Some shared targets among YIBIN FENG, YIBIN FENG formula and Liu Wei Di Huang declaration and COVID-19, which mainly regulate NF-kappa B inflammatory related pathway, have been analyzed and explained by Chinese medicine theories and modern research theories. For clinical trial, we hope to use this combination for the following outcomes. Primary outcomes will be focused on change of fatigue symptoms. Second outcomes will be focused on change of biochemical parameters. So here is our research design. The study is a random double-blind clinical research. We will use fill out the some symptoms and fatigue scale and category the patients in different groups. Take blood test again, twice. And finally, we will analyze the data to see whether the combination of Chinese herbal formulas can improve COVID-19 related susceptible bodies and enhance the body defense. We also think some risk of specific TCM treatment. For some symptoms, we will stop the use of the formulas if we find some symptoms in here. Here is our schedules, about 1 year's project. Conclusion. As conclusion, Chinese medicine is an intangible culture heritage of China, supporting the development of Chinese medicine with its experience and multidisciplinary research or integrating it into the mainstream medical system may achieve promising progress for COVID-19 treatment and prevention. In the presentation, we brief introduce the general COVID-19 pandemic and Chinese medicine used in COVID-19 in mainland China and Hong Kong. We use YIBIN FENG and the Liu Wei Di Huang formula as the sample to explore its network pharmacology and RCT plans. Thank you for your attention. Thank you very much.